Hey guys, it's Newt17. I know I didn't publish a, I haven't posted a LGBT video in a while. I did make one, and I said a lot of personal stuff in it that I don't think I'm ready to, put on the internet for everyone. So that's not going up for at least a while. I should have thought about that before I made it, but. Today I'm going to talk about stereotypes, and when I was when I started thinking about making this video, I realized that I make a lot of videos centered around myself, and I don't do that on purpose. I kind of make it about myself because I can understand it better if it's from my point of view, and all right, stereotypes of the LGBT community. A stereotype I see a lot is that gay guys don't have a deep voice. They have a high-pitched voice, and that they aren't strong and they, aren't athletic, I guess. And or like with certain sports. As a football player that paints his nails, I get a lot of crap for that. And, I don't like it at all. But, it's because they're affected by stereotypes. They don't think, football players that are athletes and strong and tough, can't paint their nails, And I understand that's just kind of how society is because that's kind of just how. Like how it's always been, but it's not true. I paint my nails and I'm gay and I'm not weak. I can bench a lot more than some of the people on the team, and I've taken out, and by taken out, I mean I've, we've been into, aggressive situations with other people on the team and I've won, I'm not weak, and I wouldn't say that I'm, macho or strong or anything. I'm just saying that there's a certain connotation because that I paint my nails, and my social class isn't, top of the line, So the stereotypes of a football player and the stereotypes of someone who's gay are kind of opposites, at least where I'm from. And that's you should you can see why that's an issue for me. And getting around stereotypes, it kind of requires you proving yourself, which shouldn't be like that, but it kind of just is. And I don't really know what else to say about that other than like. That's just kind of how it is, I paint my nails and I had to prove to people that I wasn't a little bitch. I got called a little bitch a lot. And I had to prove to people that I wasn't. And I didn't have to. But, I didn't like people to have that opinion of me. So I changed that. And being a football player, people just expected me to act a certain way, especially people in my house. You're a football player. That means you're snobby and a jock, and they didn't really like football players. And they were like, oh, you don't act a certain way, that means you can't like football. But I've never really been a person to conform to stereotypes. I don't act stereotypically gay. My mom said to me when I came out that she still doesn't think I'm gay because I've always acted a certain way. And she quotes Macklemore and says, I've liked girls since before pre-K. And she doesn't know that. And one, liking a girl in kindergarten, even, that doesn't mean, I feel attracted to women. You're in kindergarten. It's not the same. Two, I don't know. I have a lot of points against that. Once she says that, I just kind of think like that's how she's always perceived me. There's been a miscommunication. That I act a certain way, therefore I want this. And that's not how it works, but I don't just. And, some other people in my family think, you're a guy, therefore you can't actually like other guys. It's all an act and it's fake and this and that, and you just do it for attention and whatever. And I hate that because I was kind of raised by a lot of people in my family to think people that, act stereotypically gay do it for attention, and wanting attention like that is wrong. And I disagree. I don't do anything really for attention like that because I was raised that doing things for attention like that is wrong. I don't agree with that, but when I do that, I feel guilty. So, I can't really get away from that right now. I'm trying to, get out of habits of thinking like that, but it's kind of hard to do when you've been doing it for your whole life so far. And so, that's kind of led me to a place in my life where I feel guilty with a lot of the decisions I make. Like painting my nails, I don't feel guilty about that at all, but other things I kind of feel guilty about, like people that are dramatic, even. I feel like when I'm dramatic, like when I need to go to guidance, when I need to go to the guidance office to talk to a guidance counselor, I feel guilty. Like, because there were kids that would make a scene about it, and they have this entire stigma around them that, they get bad grades, they smoke pot, and they don't care about their grades, they don't care about a lot of things. And those kids, some are, tend to wear all black, and, stereotypes align with prejudice. That is a stereotype. But I don't know what that person's going through. I don't know why they need to go to guidance. I just know that they do. And, well, I know that they say they do. And I've been kind of, taught by my peers, and my family that people like that are bad. And I'm not saying they are. I'm just saying that's what I was taught. And I'm not saying I agree with that either because I know that that is prejudiced. And then I go home and they tell me prejudice is wrong and racism is wrong. But then they turn around. Some people in my family are racist. They just don't want to admit it. And some people are racist towards their own race. And they don't realize it. And I know that seems crazy that you don't realize it, but to say things like white people can't have afros, that's arguably racist. That's like saying, I mean, saying cracker to me is a racial slur. So don't say the N-word and don't say cracker. I'm not saying they're both as bad. I'm just saying if you're gonna say one, like don't say either one, 'cause they're both bad. I know that the N-word was used in harsher terms in different situations in the past in Americans' history, but America's history, sorry. But still, it's a racial slur, you know? I was raised that racism is only from white to a different race. And that's not true at all. Personally, I've seen a lot more black people be racist than white people be racist. But my personal experiences don't stand. My personal experience is that I've seen a lot more black people be racist. Doesn't stand for an entire race of like thousands of people. You know? Just 'cause, personally there's been a lot of racist black people in my life doesn't mean all black people are racist. And I've seen a lot of things like that. And I understand that prejudice, not all the time prejudice is bad. Sometimes prejudice is the only thing you have to go on. So, bad example here. Just giving you a forewarning, bad example of prejudice. If your friend said, asked you, do you want to go pet this dog? It is also rabid. You should not go pet that dog. That's prejudiced because you don't know that dog. And you're judging it before you know it. But I know it's a dog. And I know that you do know the fact that it is rabid, but it's kind of different when you know the fact that that person is a certain race or belongs to a certain group of people, you know? So that's how it's different to me. And I know that is how it's different, but like, it brings up a good point, you know? It is prejudice, but you do know one thing about the person that, you know, makes you not want to be around them or be against them or something. And there are sometimes good reasons, but usually there aren't. And usually prejudice is used wrongly. And stereotypes and prejudice pretty much, you know, fall in the same line. And so people see my nails and they're prejudiced a lot of the time. They see my nails and they think, oh, he's a crossdresser, or oh, he's gay. Usually I get, lately I've been getting a lot of crossdresser or transgender. I'm not that. Not that there's anything wrong with that, but that's not me, you know? I don't get mad when somebody's like, you're gay, and a straight person takes offense to it, you know? Because I know that to a lot of people, gay is seen as a bad thing, and they don't want to have a bad reputation. And to an extent, that offends me, you know. If you want to impress those people that are prejudiced, why would you? But, you know, that's all them. That's how they feel. And I personally don't really care if somebody objects to being called gay. When people call me gay, which has happened today, it happens like every day. I usually, depending on who I'm talking to, I'm just like, yep, it's pretty much a fact, especially for people who don't know. On the PlayStation today, this squeaker is a term used to describe a group of people. So there you go. Like, it depends on how strict you want to be with it. That is a term used to describe a specific group of people. Is it kind of offensive? It could be seen as that way. But we can all agree that it's not as bad as the N-word. And the group of people are, it's not as serious, you know? So, I use squeaker because you just sometimes, you can't get rid of some things. And I could say this young person, and I could be completely politically correct, because I like it when people are politically correct about LGBT, well, not LGBT necessarily. If people want to say gay, straight, you don't have to say heterosexual, homosexual. I don't know anybody who cares about that. If people want to say LGBT, that's great. But if people want to say queer, whatever word they want to use, if you want to be technical, I'm bisexual, but I just say gay because to me, it's not that much of a difference. If it really matters that much to you, I'm pansexual if you want to get really deep into it. That's what she said. That, I guess, is also not right to say because saying that something is directed towards what a group of women would say is prejudice. But you know, there's so much you can go. You know, it. Somebody just joined the PlayStation party. I want to make sure that they can't hear me. So, as I was saying, there's only so far you can go. You can be politically correct all day, but for me, you don't need to be too politically correct because too much political correctness, if that's a, that's not a word, but is almost censoring. And I don't know that much about censorship, honestly, so I think all forms of political correctness, not saying what's on your mind, not being allowed to say what's on your mind, is censoring. But sometimes censoring is kind of good, and it has its downsides. Everything has an up and a down. But as I was gonna say earlier, that's a topic for another day. But as I was gonna say earlier, with you know, I kind of would really like people in my house to be politically correct towards LGBT, but Then I said not necessarily, because if people aren't politically correct towards LGBT in this recording, oh my God, my gun has. Yeah, let's just don't look at my gun. That's kind of embarrassing. I didn't mean to equip that. God damn it. It's a joke. It's a joke to all the people that are like, yeah, I know. Okay. It's embarrassing. It's not, I don't actually like. Okay, see? This is what I mean. Now I feel guilty because I was taught that people that embrace being gay, that's wrong. It's just people don't embrace being straight, but it's because being gay is a minority. People embrace their race if it's a minority. Not necessarily not all people. Not all race. You don't have to be a minority to embrace that race. But well, I don't know. What do you think would happen if a white person embraced that they were white? I mean, I don't know. I feel like that's is that I don't know. I don't know. Anyway, excuse me. Coming down with something. As I was saying, what was I gonna say? God damn it. I was talking about LGBT being politically correct. That I don't need so much as I need you to not assign gender roles. You know, like pretty much everyone in my family besides like two people and people that I'm close to in my family, like really close, like I see every day, think that, you know, painting your nails is not right as a guy. Painting your nails is for girls, and if you're a guy that paints their nails, you are not a guy. Even if you have a penis, they still think you're not a man, you know, like a real man. And to me, a real man is wanting to be a real man. If you want to be a real man, you're a real man. To an I'm gonna excuse me, sorry. I don't want to add too many jump cuts because whatever. Yeah, real man. So I know that, you know, that whole real man thing has really brought me down. You know, real men have to go into the military. Real men have to do this and that. Real men, you know, stick with their wife and kids and don't leave their family. And I was raised that way. And so it affects how I think, whether I want it to or not. And that kind of sucks. You know? So I feel guilty a lot about not necessarily not painting my nails, but other things. I already said that. But, you know, all the time, my mother says these things like, men, all men do this, all men do that, and I am a man. I 100%, like, you know, identify as a man. I do have feminine traits, but I'm still a man, like 110%. So, that's prejudiced, and that's stereotyping, and that's not politically correct, and yeah, but and so that's what I feel strongly about being politically correct, and at least being respectful towards LGBT, especially pronouns. Someone that I know, has really strong opinions about transgender, especially transgender bathrooms being, you know, a big ordeal right now, a big, what's it called, controversial. You know, they're not really, they're homophobic, so they don't like gay people, never mind transgenders. And, I have no problem with them. You know, if you're transgender, you know what, I like, honestly, that's better. Because then being, well, it's better than being transgender, not being open about it or never realizing it. Always feeling uncomfortable in your skin is miserable. Never mind being the wrong gender. Being uncomfortable in your skin because of your weight, because of your height, is bad. Never mind being your gender. I'd be really uncomfortable if I had girl parts and people treated me with those gender roles all day. And I understand that there have to be at least something to keep it all intact. Because if you treat men and women the same, there's no denying the fact that men and women are just different in some ways that you can't change. But I don't think they should be treated exactly the same. Equally, yes. Exactly the same, no. Individually, every person, I could see why not, because that's very hard to do, to treat everybody differently. Because there's a lot of people in the world. Kids in my grade get all mad about how, they don't need to learn algebra for what they want to do. I don't need to learn algebra for what I want to do, depending on if I change my mind. I'm really into cryptology, but I plan to be a police officer. I don't need algebra for that, But I could definitely see how this, education system has to apply to every kid that goes to that school. And if there were a kid that needed algebra in their line of work in the future, they need it in school. And school can only be individualized to an extent. I have a problem with this word. Extracurricular activities kind of try to point a person to try out new things or to experiment with new things and try out different subjects and to see what they're into. And in terms of like education and etc. Man, I really am not feeling well. There may have to be a part two to this. What was I gonna say? Things can only be individualized to an extent, and after that, I understand that you do have to categorize people because I wrote something down. And I'm not gonna say exactly what it was because I really like it and I want people to quote me on it, not someone to steal this, steal watch this video and steal this quote, because I really like this quote. It's along the lines of so many different groups of people would create different opinions because a group of people tend to stick together. Because they have something in common that they, feel strongly about usually. There's something that they feel strongly about. And I can see why they all try to stick together. I do, stick together with other Jews, and other LGBT community members and a lot of things. Football players, I surround myself with people that we have things in common with. That's completely understandable and right. But too much differing would create a division in whatever community. So I could see why being individual, too individual, would cause an issue, and I can see why having categories creates a big difference. But if everybody were grouped together, you would have, excuse me, nobody would be individual. There would be no freedom. If everybody's grouped together, nobody has, it's harder for people to find people that they, feel the same about. I don't know, if there were no temple in my town, I would just have to find other Jews. And if we were all grouped with Christians, I'm not saying that's bad. I'm just saying we would have no way to discuss how we feel about things related to that. Different interests and different, how people identify call for different groups. And this has been a long conversation. I'm going to try to wrap it up 1 minute. So in conclusion, I think I should make a part two to this. Can I really talk for an hour about this? Damn, I didn't. I mean, at the first 10, 15 minutes of the video, I felt really shy, and so I was pretty. I don't know. It's hard to explain. I wasn't explaining things well. prejudice sometimes isn't bad because that's the only thing you have to go on. Same with stereotypes. Diversity is diversity can create, separation, and too much similarity lacks freedom and individualization, individualism. I don't know how to say that. And political correctness, whatever. You can only go so far. You know, there's a bad side and a good side, and you know, a good middle area for everything. Stereotypes, prejudice, political correctness, and diversity. So everything needs to have a balance, and it's hard to find that balance sometimes. You know, I find myself affected every day by prejudice. I look at a person and I judge them, and it's impossible. I've talked to my counselor about this. Everybody does it, whether they want to admit it or not. Maybe not immediately once they look at someone, but when you can never stop. Your mind doesn't just shut off. When you sleep, you dream. You're always thinking, whether you think you are or not, even subconsciously. So you look at a person, and you automatically have these things that you recognize and you associate with what you see. And so the way I was taught, I can't help but have some of the prejudices I have. And I'm trying to get over that. And I'm trying to get over the fact that how people are isn't a bad thing, necessarily. Embracing your gayness or whatever isn't a bad thing. And I'm trying to get over that, so I paint my nails and stuff. Oh, excuse me. Jeez. And so I'm trying to get over my prejudice, and I'm trying to get over my, how I was taught to feel about stereotypes and political correctness. I'm trying to find a good middle area for that. I haven't found that yet. And diversity. I think diversity is good for the most part. I've seen a lot more, you know, separation from it than I have, you know, alliances. Because alliances can cause exclusion. But that's I gotta end the video. So, please tell me if you like this, because it took a lot of work. I've been talking for a half an hour. Watch this get 0 views, man. I'm gonna be quite upset. But, you know, over time people will watch it. Hopefully people, you know, feel as strongly about it as I do. I didn't think that I felt this strongly about it to talk for 27 minutes and 50 whatever seconds. Make sure to like the video if you liked it. Subscribe and please spread the word so that, you know, these half an hour talks don't go to waste. And subscribe if you want more content like this. And